Hello students, welcome to my next video. Today we'll be doing the question number 10 of page number 166. Okay, now the following is a balance sheet of Om and Jay on 31st March 2018. They share profit and losses in the ratio 3:2. Now in today's sum, what is the new thing we are learning is, you can see the question carefully, there is a current account also. Means along with the capital account, there is a balance of current account also. So, in today's problem, we will be preparing partner's current account instead of partner's capital account. You will be preparing partner's current account. Okay. Now, then we will just read the adjustment. They take Jagdish into partnership on 1st April 2018. The terms being, Jagdish should pay 3,000 as his share of goodwill. That means 3,000 is the goodwill which is brought by Jagdish. And 50% of goodwill withdrawn by partners in cash. He should bring 9,000 as capital for 1/4 share in future profit. So this is, he should bring 9,000. That means it is the additional capital what is brought by the new partner. Building to be valued at 18,000. So tick mark building. Then you have machinery and furniture to be reduced by 10%. So tick mark machinery and furniture. Then you have a provision of 5% on debtors to be made for doubtful debts. So it is RDD. So we will tick mark debtors. Then we have stock is to be taken at a value of 15,000. The stock to be taken at a value of 15,000. So tick mark stock also. Prepare profit and loss account, partner's current account and balance sheet of the new firm. So students, so we will be solving the sum. So now what all things we are preparing? We are preparing revaluation account, partner. Now remember, in partner's current account, when we are preparing, the partner's current account will be prepared only for the old partners. So we have made only two columns, so Om and J. Om and J. Remember, here we will not make three columns for partners. How we make for partner's capital account? It is a partner's current account. So partner's current account is only prepared for the old partners, not for the new partners. Then we prepare cash account. So this is cash account. So this is particulars, amount, particulars and amount. Then we will prepare goodwill account. This is particulars, amount, particulars, amount. And we have admitted the new partner Jagdish into partnership on 1st April 2018. So new balance sheet as on 1st April 2018. This is liabilities, amount, assets, amount and amount. Okay, so now this is the new balance sheet what is prepared. Now after this we will start posting. The first one is cash account given to you. So cash account debit side it is given to you. So we write on debit side two balance brought down. It is an opening balance of capital account, 3,000 rupees. Then you have building. So building is assets. So building, which is 15,000, inner column. Then machinery, which is 21,000. Then furniture, 900 rupees. Stock, which is 12,300. Then debtors, which is 27,000. In the inner column, then on liabilities, you have creditors. Creditors is a liabilities 30,000. Then capital account you have. So as it is a fixed capital method, how we came to know it's a fixed capital method? Because here the current account is given to you, so it is a fixed capital method. So you will write capital. How we write in the final account? Same way, write directly in the liability side. Om, J, and the new partner Jagdish. So Om has brought 21,000. J 21,000. Okay, and Jagdish we will see when it will come. Then you have current account balance of Om and J. Current account balance, it is given on credit side. So write on credit side, by balance brought on credit side 3750 and 3450. So we write on credit side 3750, 3450. Come to the adjustment number 1. They take Jagdish into partnership on 1st April 2018, the terms being Jagdish should pay 3000 as his share of goodwill. Jagdish should pay 3000 as his share of goodwill. That means Jagdish is bringing 3000 for goodwill. So the entry, if you see the entry, it is cash account debited to goodwill account. Paisa aa raha hai. Cash account debited to goodwill account. So posting cash account ke debit side mein, cash account ke debit side mein to goodwill account 3000 rupees. And who is credited goodwill account? So write on credit side of goodwill account by cash account 3000 rupees. By cash account 3000 rupees. Then the goodwill amount is distributed among the partners. So we write goodwill account debited to the old partners current account. Now who are the old partners? Om, current account, J, current account. So the amount of goodwill is 3000. You have to distribute in the ratio 3:2. So 3000 into 3/5, 3000 into 2/5. Because the ratio is 3:2, so you will distribute the goodwill amount in the ratio 3:2. So 3000 into 3/5, 3000 into 2/5. So you will be getting 1800 and 1200. 1800 and 1200. So the posting is goodwill account debit side to Om current account to J current account 1800 and 1200. Second effect, partners current account credit side by goodwill account 1800 and 1200. Now 50% of goodwill withdrawn in cash, यानी कि जो goodwill amount है उसका 50% विड्रॉ हुआ है, तो व्हेन इट इज विड्रॉन, सो व्हाट इज द जर्नल एंट्री? ओल्ड पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट डेबिटेड टू, ओल्ड पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट डेबिटेड टू गुड कैश और बैंक अकाउंट, बिकॉज विड्रॉन मतलब क्या होता है कि पार्टनर अपने बिजनेस से पैसा लेके जा रहा है, यानी कि वो लोग बिजनेस में पैसा रखेंगे, दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू री इन्वेस्ट द मनी वॉट एवर इज रिसीव्ड इन द गुडविल, तो वो लोग क्या कर रहे हैं, वो अपने घर पे लेके जा रहे हैं, सो दे आर टेकिंग इट होम. तो वॉट विल बी द जर्नल एंट्री? जर्नल एंट्री विल बी द पार्टनर इज अ रिसीवर. एंट्री क्या है, देखो वापस से बता रहा हूँ, एंट्री क्या होगा, ओल्ड पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट डेबिटेड, ओल्ड पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट डेबिटेड टू, ओल्ड पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट डेबिटेड टू कैश और बैंक अकाउंट. सो ओल्ड पार्टनर्स के डेबिट में लिखो, ओल्ड पार्टनर्स के डेबिट में लिखो टू कैश अकाउंट, टू कैश अकाउंट टू कैश अकाउंट विच इज हाफ. तो यहां पे देखो कितना उनका 1800 था, 1800 का हाफ, 1800 का हाफ कितना आएगा 900 रुपया, और 1200 का हाफ कितना आएगा 600 रुपया. 1800 का हाफ 900 रुपया, 1200 का हाफ 600 रुपया, क्योंकि पूरा विड्रॉ नहीं किया, पूरा लेके नहीं गया, दे हैव विड्रॉन ओनली 50%. सो 50% विड्रॉन हुआ है, तो 1800 का हाफ 900, 1200 का हाफ हो गया 600. इसका सेकेंड इफेक्ट, पैसा जा रहा है बिजनेस से, पैसा जा रहा है, सो वी राइट ये बाय ओम करंट अकाउंट बाय जे करंट अकाउंट 900 एंड 600. देन He should bring 9,000 as capital for 1/4 share in future profit. तो he is bringing 9,000 in the business. वो 9,000 लेके आ रहा है बिजनेस में. तो he is bringing 9,000. तो एंट्री क्या आएगा इसका? कैश अकाउंट डेबिटेड. कैश पैसा आ रहा है. कैश अकाउंट डेबिटेड टू जगदीश कैपिटल अकाउंट विच इज 9,000 रुपीज. And this is a capital balance. This is a capital balance. So in front of Jagdish, this is a capital balance. In front of Jagdish, you write 9,000. In front of Jagdish, you write 9,000. So 50, 1,000. So 9,000 is a capital. So we are not preparing capital account. So we directly write in the balance sheet liability side. That is 9,000 rupees. So 21 plus 9 is 30. 30 plus 21 is 51,000. This you are writing in the balance sheet liability side. So first effect is when the new partner brings cash into the business, to cash account debited. To cash account ke debit mein likha 2 Jagdish capital account and liabilities mein likha Jagdish 9,000 rupees. So total karo you will be getting 51,000. Okay, then third adjustment, building to be valued at 18,000. Building to be valued at 18,000. तो building के outer column में लिखो 18,000. Building पहले कितना था 15,000, अभी कितना हुआ 18,000. यानी building का value बढ़ गया है, तो हम लोग क्या करेंगे इसको, appreciation. बढ़ गया ना, पहले 15,000 था, अभी 18,000 हो गया, यानी ये बढ़ गया. कितने से बढ़ गया? 3,000 से बढ़ गया. सो ये एप्रिसिएशन हुआ है. बिल्डिंग पहले था 15,000, अभी हुआ है 18,000, यानी बिल्डिंग का वैल्यू 3,000 से बढ़ गया है. तो इट इज अवर प्रॉफिट. तो प्रॉफिट को हम कहाँ लिखेंगे? रिवैल्यूएशन अकाउंट के क्रेडिट साइड में. बाय बिल्डिंग अकाउंट 3,000. बाय बिल्डिंग अकाउंट रुपीज 3,000. पहला इफेक्ट कहाँ लिखा आपने? बिल्डिंग में अपने ऐड किया. पहला इफेक्ट अपने बिल्डिंग में ऐड किया. और दूसरा इफेक्ट आपने क्या किया है? यू हैव रिटन इन रिवैल्यूएशन अकाउंट के क्रेडिट साइड में बाय बिल्डिंग अकाउंट 3,500. This is revaluation account. Then the next is machinery and furniture to be reduced by 10%. Machinery and furniture to be reduced by 10%. So less depreciation 10%. Less depreciation 10%. So 21,000 का 10% कितना आएगा? 2,100. 21,000 का 10%. How we got this 10%? 21,000 into 10 upon 100. So 18,900. Okay. So furniture pay be 90 rupees 10%. It will be 810 rupees. Second effect, depreciation is a loss for the business. Depreciation is a loss for the business. So we write in revaluation account debit side to machinery account, which is 2,100, to furniture account, which is 90 rupees. Then provision of 5% on debtors to be made for doubtful debts. A provision of 5% on debtors to be made for doubtful debts. So provision, so doubtful debts. So this is RDD. So we write here new RDD. So it is 5%. So 2,700 ka 5%, it will be 1,350. How we got this? 27,000 into 5 upon 100. So 27 into 5, you will be getting 1,350. 0, 5, 9 mein se 3 gets 6. 6 में से गन गए 5, यू विल बी गेटिंग 25,650. सेकेंड इफेक्ट, टू आरडीडी अकाउंट 1,350, टू आरडीडी अकाउंट 1,350. देन stock is to be taken at a value of rupees 15,000. The value of stock is 15,000. The value of stock is 15,000. पहले था 12,300, अभी है 15,000. तो यानी वैल्यू बढ़ गया है. इसको हम लिखेंगे appreciation. So you will be getting 2,700. So value बढ़ गया है, तो it is appreciation. So we write in credit side by stock account 2,700, by stock account 2,700. So now we close the account. So in this sum, in today's sum, I think we are doing page number 166, question number 10, current account sum. Now we close the account. So total the account. So debit side 3,000 plus 2,700, you will be getting 5,700. And here if I add, I'm getting 0,434. If I'm adding this 0, 9 plus 5, 14, 1, 3, 4, 5. So 3,540. So from this very clear that credit side is heavier. So credit side ka amount dono baju likho. Abhi dono ko minus karo, upar likh do. 0, सिक्स, सिक्स में से वन और ये टू, 2160, सो इट विल बी टू पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट, अंडरलाइन इट, ओ जे 2160 इंटू 3/5, 2160 इंटू 2/5, 2160 इंटू 3/5, सो यू विल बी गेटिंग 5 4 20 1, 5 3 15, 5 2 10, सो मल्टीप्लाइंग दिस 3 2 6, 3 3 9, 3 4 12, सो 2 2 4, 2 3 6, 2 4 8. ओके, सो दिस इज अ, सो 2000, यू सी कैलकुलेशन, दैट इज मल्टीप्लाई एंड देन डिवाइड, मल्टीप्लाइंग डिवाइडिंग, सो यू विल बी गेटिंग 1296 एंड 864. दिस विल बी ट्रांसफर टू बाय रिवैल्यूएशन अकाउंट, इन ब्रैकेट यू राइट प्रॉफिट 1296864. So now you add up so you will be getting 6 9 10 14 16 to 18 3 4 5 6 6 8 4 6 6 8 4 6, again if you add this 4 6 plus 5 11 4 7 15 3 4 5 4, so you add up this 4 5 11 1 5 7 10 7 10 15 1 carry 3 4 5 5 5, so 5 5 1 4, माइनस करो 600 से तो ये पे आएगा 4 9 1 4, माइनस करो 900 से 6 4 9 5 9 4 6, सो दिस इज द टू बैलेंस कैरी डाउन, दिस इज द करंट अकाउंट बैलेंस. सो डेबिट में डिफरेंस आया है तो इट विल कम ऑन क्रेडिट साइड, करंट अकाउंट, अंडरलाइन इट, बिकॉज करंट अकाउंट का बैलेंस किधर भी आ सकता है, इट कैन कम ऑन डेबिट साइड, इवन इट कैन कम ऑन क्रेडिट साइड ऑल्सो. सो इफ इट इज ऑन डेबिट साइड, सो इट विल बी ट्रांसफर टू क्रेडिट साइड ऑफ न्यू बैलेंस शीट. क्रेडिट साइड ऑफ न्यू बैलेंस शीट इज लाइबिलिटी, सो राइट हियर करंट अकाउंट, वी राइट हियर ओ एंड वी राइट हियर जे, सो 5 9 4 6 4 9 1 4 4 5 6 18 10 8 16. So now close cash account 3 6 3 6 9 10 12 15,000. 15,000 minus 1,500, you will be getting 13,500. Right here by balance carry down. देखो यहाँ 15,000 है टोटल, यहाँ पे सिर्फ 1,500 है, तो 15,000 में से 1,500 माइनस करो, कितना मिलेगा आपको 13,500. दिस इज कैश विच इज 13,500. नाउ क्लोज गुडविल अकाउंट, it is tally both the side 3000 and 3000. So now total up, so you will be getting 0 6 8 1 91,860. same way you total this one, so that's all, our sum got tallied. Thank you, students.